What's up, B&B fam? All right, we're doing another B&B workout today. I'm using a 20-pound dumbbell. You can use whatever weight works for you. I'll be hitting the punching bag, and you can shadow box, of course, with the combo of the day that we're using. We're gonna be doing back and buns, so glute exercises today, and 1 minute round increments, so you can go as long or as short as you like for this workout. Grab your B&B gloves. We're gonna jump rope as well, and you know you can do everything with those gloves. And yeah, grab your stuff and let's go. Getting in our jump rope for our warm up today. So we're gonna go for a minute here on the jump rope. You can always do a couple of minutes, do what you need to warm up. You know, I usually do jump rope and then I do shadow boxing. You can always mix that up and go shadow boxing, then jump rope. You can also mix it up and add this jump rope round in between your boxing and your weight training. But anyways, make sure that you are warming up. If you're roping, elbows are in, shoulders are relaxed, those hands are slightly in front of you, rotating at the wrists, and making sure you're not really jumping too high off the ground. We're just working on timing, rhythm, coordination, and getting that heart rate up, loosening everything up. And warming those muscles up, getting ready for a nice little B&B workout. And here we're gonna get into our shadow boxing. So move around, let it flow. The combo we're gonna be working on today, I'll show you on the bag, obviously, which you just saw right there, actually. It's a 1-2, we're gonna step and pivot and then throw a right hand. So there it is again. So when you're doing it on the bag, you're going, or shadow boxing, you're gonna be throwing other things in between there as well. So now on the punching bag here, kind of setting everything up, nice and loose, getting the range, always send that jab. And you can see that I just fired that combo right there. But I will slow it down for you guys, and we'll go over exactly how to throw this combo. So that you guys can practice it and get the mechanics of it down. Step on your jab to the left slightly, drag the back foot slightly to the left on the right hand, step to the left, pivot, so making sure that front heel is up when you pivot, and then throwing that right hand. Now the reason for the step and the pivot when you're on the bag is that if you just pivot, that bag will no longer be in front of you. So on a punching bag, if you're pivoting, it's crucial that you do a step first. So that's why we're utilizing this combo to hit the bag. All right, and our first weight block here, we're gonna be doing, we're actually doing kind of a lunge, picking up the buns, and then we're rowing. So this is a single arm row, drop down, pick it up. You're gonna feel it in your glute and your hamstring when you do that. Stay nice and controlled in your movement. Pull the weight to the hip and keep that back nice and flat when you do these, and you're gonna alternate the other side in your next circuit. All right, now we're back on that bag. We're gonna be firing those shots up, nice and warmed up here. Again, always getting that range. Fire whatever you wanna fire, but then always incorporate that combination in between. So always thinking, how can I set up this combination? That's what we're looking at on here. If you don't feel comfortable doing that yet, just work on the combo and build up that combo. So you can start with the jab, start with the 1-2, then add in the step pivot, then add the right hand in, add in some defense. So if you're not advanced yet and you don't feel really comfortable on the bag, just stick with the combo of the day and work it, build it up. Now we're moving on to our next weight block. Now we're going into regular RDLs here, and then we're gonna do a bent over row, and we're pulling right to the hips on that dumbbell. This is a 20-pound dumbbell. Making sure that those hips pull back, making sure you have a nice strong core when you're doing this. Focus on your glutes. Pull your shoulders back, stick your chest out. Pull through those heels, like really drive through those heels. We wanna save the back, so making sure you do not round the back. We're trying to stay as flat as we can in the back and hinge those hips back. So really stick those buns back when you do these. All right, another round of boxing. We're back on that bag. again, we're firing that jab, setting things up. You see me, sometimes I'll do a little feint. I did a little kind of step over there. Just mixing it up. Again, I don't really think too much when I'm working on my bag or shadow boxing, but I think enough to kind of figure out like what's coming next. If I throw this, what are they gonna do? That all happens internally when you've been doing boxing for so many years. But if you're a beginner, again, just go back to the combo. It never fails. The combo's always there for you. Build it right back up. This kind of bag work takes time, but the more you do it, the better you're gonna get. You're gonna have more tools, more things in your arsenal to work with. So don't worry about it if you're not getting fancy right now. Just work on the combo. And then our last weight block, we're gonna be doing some squats. These are goblet squats. And the reason I do these is because it really engages your whole core. And like I said, this is a back and a buns workout. So we're engaging the back muscles here, the ab muscles, and the glutes as well. We're, again, making sure those hips come back, press through those heels. Shoulders are back and chest is out like every weight exercise that you're gonna do. Now let's go ahead and repeat this all over again.